So we're here with David from Kessel Lighting, and he's going to show us some features and tell us about the cool things with these new LEDs that they have, and also some of the grow LEDs that we use on our refugium style sump. So,
all right, yeah, great. So this year we've got the new A360X, which is behind us here. This one is the next generation of the A360, one of our most popular, probably the best selling in the industry.
Okay.
What we've done is we've reduced the size by about 30%.
Yeah, I saw that.
Increased the output by about 25%, increased the coverage a little bit, made the coverage even more even than it was before.
Awesome.
We've also created sort of a new heatsink design, so there's a almost frictionless airflow.
Okay. Is there fans in these?
There are fans. Okay. Yeah. This time, though, what it does is it's sort of self-cleaning.
Okay.
So low maintenance.
Awesome.
So the other ones you had to blow out once in a while. These ones are a lot easier to deal with.
Awesome.
Aside from that, we've also added controllability over some of the additional colors. So before we kind of locked it, now we're unlocking some of that.
Awesome.
So now you can control the red and green similar to the AP700, but also violet indigo.
Okay.
And then we've also brought the dimming down all the way.
Okay.
So now you can dim down to 1%, so no more sudden jumps.
Yes, that'd be great.
You can do moonlights. Yeah,
as I say, moonlighting.
Yep.
Awesome. So, so with the colors now, obviously it gives people a little bit more options to adjust it. So what do you recommend, though, as far as...
So most of it's just visual. Again, we lock in the core spectrum. So if you're using the Tuna Blue, as long as you're using that, it doesn't matter as much.
Okay.
As long as you kind of keep it balanced, it's not a big deal.
Awesome.
It's not like other lights where you have to kind of really get the right spectrum.
Yeah. So you had a pre-set up
exactly
to work out of the box.
Most of this is just visual. It'll have a little impact on coral growth, but not much.
Okay.
And then we've also done the color control, ultra-low dimming, the lower maintenance, lower profile design.
Yep.
K-Link, the communication is new too.
Okay.
So we do a new communication. Physically, it's a USB-C connector.
Okay.
You know, they're making them for all the phones now. They're really robust, waterproof.
Yeah.
They're a lot more rust resistant than most other new connectors. So we had to switch to a data connector, and that's the best one we could find.
Oh, yeah.
So there's no longer an input and output. You can plug it in anywhere. And as soon as you plug them in together, they can talk to each other.
Okay.
So they know what's what. The new Spectral Controller X, is one way to control them, so you get access to all the new colors. It's actually powered by the light now, so you don't have to plug it into the wall.
Nice.
So as long as you use it with the new lights, you don't have to find an extra outlet for it.
Okay.
Just powered right from them.
Eliminating cords is a good thing.
Exactly, yeah. And then next year we'll have the Wi-Fi dongle.
Okay.
So that'll plug into the lights as well, and you can just use them through the app.
Okay. When are you expecting that to be shipping?
We're hoping the Wi-Fi dongle early next year.
Okay.
Early to mid next year, and then the lights will be shipping later this year, so probably November or December.
Awesome.
And then, of course, you know, new product always going to be taken out of the market pretty quick, so you got to get your hands on it fast.
Yeah.
And then we've also got the horticulture lights. Those have been really popular for refugiums.
Yep, we use those a lot.
Exactly.
Yep.
So we've been working in the algae market for almost a decade now, and we've kind of refined that spectrum enough so nobody really can compete for the same wattage.
No, and the growth results from those are amazing.
Yeah. I mean, so we've really tried to make sure that it works well for that.
Yeah.
We recently launched the H160, which is probably like a perfect balance for most people's aquariums.
Yeah, I saw that. Normally we use like the is it the H80? I'm trying to think.
H380.
H380
is a workhorse.
Yes.
But it's bigger than most people need.
Exactly.
And it's not controllable.
No, yeah.
So we brought out the H160, so it brings the price range, you know, under 300. But it gives you controllability, still enough power for most tanks up to a few hundred gallons.
So you guys watching, that's perfect for our sumps.
Exactly.
When you're trying to grow Chato and other macroalgae.
Back in the back of our booth, we've got your sump with an H160 over it, and we also have H80 on display.
Yeah.
So H80 is just kind of like the budget option.
Yeah.
And then the H160 is primary, what most people are going to want. As you get into bigger tanks, that's when you get oh, am I holding this? Yeah, there you go. There's the H80 right there. It's got the nice maroon packaging. That way you know it's a horticulture product.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, I mean, we just kind of focused on building on what we've got, expanding the line. You know, we're not ones to come out with a new thing every year just because know, something changes.
When you have a good thing, we're the same way. You know, you don't see our product line change a lot because we build something to function and do a job. Mm-hmm. And if it's doing that job, there's usually not a reason to change it.
Yeah, we also try to anticipate what's coming up. At heart, we're a technology company.
Yeah.
And so most of what we're introducing to the market is brand new in general, not just to the aquarium market.
Exactly.
And so things we've tested over the last 5 to 10 years and then finally end up being implemented into a product.
Yeah, well, because a lot of people don't realize that you guys don't just do aquarium lighting.
Right.
You guys are really big in the movie production lighting.
Sure.
So.
Yeah, Felix brand. So yep. Yeah, I mean, our lighting is divided in different brands. Of course, like we said, Kessel is focused on spectrum-specific lighting.
Yes.
So like we said, horticulture, aquarium, photoredox, like chemical reactions and algae, that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
And then Felix, the photography one.
Yeah, those are
they're
awesome.
Focused on like museum lighting and inspection lighting and but mostly for video and for photography.
Yeah. So again, you guys out there, if you're looking for video and photography lighting, look at Kessel as well.
Yep, Felix makes every size and shape you can imagine.
Cool.
So anything you need from portable on-camera stuff to studio lighting.
Yeah.
So even some of the movies you've seen recently might have Felix behind them.
So. Yeah, I've looked at the website and some of those lights are, it's crazy. Yeah. Well, Dave.
Great.
Thanks for
taking
time.
Yeah, thanks for coming by.
Yeah.
Good to see you.
Yep.
All right. Thanks, guys.